Welcome back to Household Labs. Last time I lit up the forge, I tried to melt brass, but my thin steel crucible couldn't take the heat. I got a clay graphite crucible, and I tried to melt the same brass, but the heat didn't transfer very well through the clay graphite crucible in my forge. So I decided to build a foundry. I thought I'd pour concrete in a ring, and the crucible would fit inside, and the air would still be able to escape, but they would be able to put coal in around the edges. I have this piece of chicken wire fence that I'm going to reinforce the concrete with. I started making my mold with this flat piece of cardboard as the bottom. Then I used the top of a 5-gallon bucket as the outside ring, and this pot for planting for the inside ring. I used duct tape to cover up any of the holes in the pot and the bucket to make sure that my mixture wouldn't leak out of the mold. After sealing both sections of the mold, I filled the inner bucket with rocks to give it weight so that it wouldn't float in the concrete mixture. Next, I folded the chicken wire in half so that it would be the same height as the mold. I wrapped the wire around the mold to measure the proper length of the circumference of it. Then, using tin snips, I cut it to length. Now for the insulating mixture. I used Grant Thompson's recipe of 1 part sand to 1 part plaster of Paris. Before I added water to the mixture, I rubbed both parts of the mold with oil to lubricate it so that the mold will come off easier. Then I put the chicken wire in place and the rest of the mold together. To seal the bucket to the bottom cardboard, I used duct tape. Then I added water to the mixture and started stirring. I stirred till it had an even consistency and color. After I had started pouring, I realized that I had underestimated the amount of mixture that I would need, so it didn't quite fill it to the top. A leak also formed between the bucket and the cardboard because the tape broke, so I lost a lot of plaster mixture through that too. To seal the leak, I just let it harden about 10 minutes, and then made another batch and poured it into the mold. After about 24 hours, I removed all of the rocks from the inner bucket. Then I tried to gently peel the edges of the bucket from the inside of the ring to remove it from the mold. I removed the cardboard from the bottom and tried to clean up the edges a little bit. Then I tried to loosen the outer ring from the mold. The hardened plaster ring didn't remove itself from the outside of the mold very easily, so I set it on another spackle bucket, removed the tape, and used a wooden mallet to gently loosen it from the mold. I found that if I tapped on both sides of the mold, the outer casing would wiggle itself off. I removed the ring from the mold, but as soon as I tried to flip it over, part of the wall started to collapse. I fixed it as best I could, but I knew that this would be a weak spot. I waited another couple of days, and then started the fire in the forge, and set the ring on top to let it dry out even more. I started with a wood fire, but eventually added some coal. It seemed to withstand the heat pretty well. As soon as I put the crucible in to start preheating, it started smoking a lot, because it wasn't getting enough air. So I let it burn a little longer to get a little hotter, and then I put the crucible in, and it worked just fine. I added more coal around the crucible to try to heat things up a little bit. I used an old brake rotor as a lid to contain the heat. I noticed that when I poured coal into the foundry, a lot of it got in the crucible, so I put a steel can inside the crucible to cover it up while I was pouring. Then I just removed the steel can to put the lid back on. Once I saw the crucible starting to turn red, I added the copper to the furnace. I used copper this time instead of brass for two reasons. First of all, I knew that if I could melt copper, then I could definitely melt brass, which has a lower melting point. I also used copper because I wanted to experiment with alloying it with different metals. The next time I put the steel can in the crucible to fuel the fire, it got stuck because it expanded from the heat. Clay graphite crucibles are very fragile, so I couldn't put very much pressure on it, but I tried to twist and pry a little bit to get the can off, but it didn't work. This caused a pretty abrupt ending in the project. The next day, when everything had cooled down, I was able to get the steel can out and look at the contents of the crucible. I didn't see any evidence that any of the copper had melted, because all of the copper was still in wire shape. The rest here is just coal and ashes that had fallen into the crucible. Well, thanks for watching Household Labs, and I hope you learned something new. If you'd like to see the video about my first attempt at melting brass, there will be a link in the description and on your screen.